5 years. Who is in the house right now that has been a member for 5 years? Could you please stand, each of you? I see you back there. Hands prayer, please stand. Very good, very good. Stand up, hands around the bus. Okay, now what about 4 years? Have you been a member for at least 4 years? Can you stand up so we can see who you are? Okay, very good. Put your hand in your shirt on the garden club. We have no garden club clapping in WOAMTEC. You guys beat it up a little bit, add a caterwauler every now and then. If you don't know what a caterwauler is, I think Lisa, you might know being from Georgia. It's a yoo-hoo! And who have overcome an obstacle to reach their goal. And whether you're a fabulous man in this room or a sensational woman, I think we all know that you can read the tools, and John Maxwell, I love you, named some amazing people. You can read the tools that it takes to reach success, but it starts with what's within you, the determination, the motivation, the on-purpose passion that's required to reach success. And you know, I just feel, when we look back at over the past 5 years, I feel compelled to take a moment and talk to you about something that I'm very passionate about, because I know we are at a tipping point and God is helping us grow nationwide with Scottsdale and North Carolina and Georgia and Texas and all sorts of amazing women from all over, Tallahassee and Jacksonville and Boca Raton and West Palm Beach in the house tonight. But I want to take a moment and I want to talk about something that is touching my heart right now. A lot of people went out after our fabulous social when we recognized our amazing leaders. A lot of people went out. I went back to my room because I, too, wanted to watch the debate. And I don't care which way you're going, left or right, or what you're thinking, or how confused you may be in this room right now, but the passion that I'm hearing that I want to take a moment to address today is there's been a lot of focus on women in business. How can we strategically, politically position ourselves to tap into appealing to women in business? There's been a lot of focus on middle-class America and small business management. That pulls at my heart, and you want to know why it pulls at my heart? Because I am connected to small business. I am connected to middle-class America. And I can tell you in the last 5 years, I've seen members come and go because they've lost their jobs. I've seen members have to start new companies because they had to close their old ones. I have seen members give up houses, give up cars, go back to school to reposition themselves. It touches my heart. Whether you're Obama or Romney, I don't know if they can relate to what it's like to get a knock on the door at 5 a.m. because your Land Rover is being repossessed. Whether you're Obama or Romney, I don't know if they can relate to what it's like to tell your mother that they have to move out of their house because you can no longer afford to pay their mortgage too. Because 8 years ago, 10 years ago, if you were a middle-class small business owner, you might have been able to afford luxuries like that. You might have been able to afford having those extra benefits. Whether you're Romney or Obama, I don't know if they know what it's like to look at an employee and say, I'm sorry, I'm gonna have to let you go, because it's easier to fire them than to say, I can't give you the benefits that I've been giving you for the last 5 years, and I can't give you health insurance anymore because I can't afford $2,700 a month. Those are decisions that we have been faced with. Those are decisions that I know you've been faced with. Those are decisions I have personally been faced with in the last 5 years. You know what's the difference between all of these women and what's the difference between everybody in this room? Is it doesn't matter what taxes are cut, it doesn't matter what gifts were given, what new benefits are created, what new positions are happening. Everybody in this room will continue to shine and will continue to thrive. You know why? Because we know that when you get knocked down as an entrepreneur, as a small business owner, as a management, someone in leadership, we know to lift that employee up. We know to throw our shoulders back, and we know to keep forward, and we know that it doesn't matter what happens in November, if we're gonna make it to December, and if we're we're going to thrive in 2013, it is up to me. It is up to us. It's about working together. We know that by creating a sisterhood, by connecting someone from North Carolina with someone in Orlando, by connecting someone from Scottsdale with someone in Georgia, by saying, you know what, girlfriend, what do you need and how can I help you? How can I pick you up? How can we pull together our resources? If we can't afford a vendor table anymore, let's come together and do it together. If we can't afford to advertise and do direct mail, let's come together and do it together. If we can't throw the fancy Christmas parties that we used to, let's all get together and do one at one, the same time, at the same hotel, the same night, and make ourselves look even better, because it's about working together. And we know that it's that accountability, that time management, that work effort that we're going to put into everything that we say and do, that we're going to make it through. And together, we can rebuild America. I believe that. I hope you do too. When you're at your worst, and I know we're not out of the darkness, I know some of us are sitting in this room right now thinking, I'm at my worst, girlfriend. I haven't told anybody yet. I have a smile on my face, and my lipstick's on it. Damn, I'm looking good. But I don't know how I'm going to pay my rent next month. I don't know where I'm going to live next month. I don't know what I'm going to do. What I can tell you is this. If you move forward in faith, and you move forward without fear, and know that there is a bigger plan and a better plan. This was not my plan. You've heard it before. I used to teach marketing and business courses, how to write business plans at a university in Florida. I didn't have a business plan for WOAMTEC. This was not my plan. This was no different than what you have experienced when God took something bad in your life and made it good. He took something when I thought it was at my best. Bad things happened. And now we're changing and making a difference across America. That's huge. That's happening in your life right now too. And if it is too dark for you to see, if you don't understand what is supposed to come out of this, if you don't know how you can shine light, I want you to remember something. Everybody has a ring on your desk, on your table. That was the teacher me that flashed back up on your desk. I haven't said that about 20 years. Okay, it's a ring. If you need help, ask the people around you to help you figure out how to assemble it onto your finger. But we did this for a reason. Because, you know, some people have lucky coins that you can just kind of put in your pocket. This you can either put it on or leave it in your pocket. Whenever you're faced with a dark situation, you have two choices. You can either choose to light up the world or burn out the fuse. Okay? Light up the world or burn out the fuse. If you walk into a room and you've got all this negative stuff happening in your life, you can either choose to share it, or you can turn on the light and know that there is a plan. When you walk into a room and you're faced with a difficult situation and you don't know how you're going to take the next step, if you keep moving forward and know that if you focus on making Araya feel better, or if you focus on making Vanessa feel better, it'll all work out because you're turning on the light instead of blowing out the fuse. I empower each and every one of you with the ability to turn on the light in the lives of others, and I trust you, if you take the focus off yourself, and I know it's hard when you feel like you're drowning and nobody's throwing that vest out to you to save you, if you take the focus off yourself and put it on others and shine the light on the person next to you, everybody do it right now, shine the light on the person next to you. So take a deep breath. Commit to yourself that no matter what you're faced with between the end of 2012 in all of 2013, know that we can rebuild the economy, we can rebuild America, and we can make a difference in the lives of others if you turn on the light instead of blowing out the fuse. Thank you so much for being here today.